Welcome back to Every Further Mile. So, we went to Cape Breton. We actually have broken this up in four videos, only because there was so much for us to see. This video is about our first day where we went to the Fortress of Louisbourg.
Oui, oui.
It's a really cool little town, actually, and Nathan's gonna tell you a little bit about it.
In 1720 is when the fortress started being built by the French in what was then Acadia. And then in 1745, British colonists took it over. It was given back to the French as a bargaining chip in another war, and it was conquered again in 1758 for the last time by the British, who dismantled the fort.
Really? There was actually nothing there for a really long time. And then it was in 1970s that they actually started to rebuild. It's taken about 50 years to get it to the point that you're gonna see it in this video. Now you get to go in, and they actually have actors there for Nathan, I think, and Corbin, especially. They were more of the history. I think Wilder probably just enjoyed running around. For me, I felt like Belle in Beauty and the Beast. And in fact, began singing a little bit from the movie, the songs. I love Disney Princess movies, and I love singing, and that's probably a part of it. And so I got to sing some songs from Beauty and the Beast while in this adorable little French village, and it was awesome. So we went to the Fortress of Louisbourg, and that was really amazing. Then we made our way over to Sydney, and Sydney was, it's a nice little city.
It's cute.
Yeah, it's cute. We just kind of did a walk along the water. Wilder loved that part.
Oh yeah, he loved the waterfront. We did expect a mini Halifax. That was not what it was. It was a cutesy little town.
Yeah.
City might be a bit of a stretch.
It's nearly 40,000 people, I think.
Yeah.
So not big, but it's...
Yeah, not big, but cute.
Yeah. We had dinner there. It was nice, and then we...
Wonton nachos. If you've never tried wonton nachos, you have to try them. So good.
It's true.
The Governor's Pub?
Yep. And the gigantic
violin.
Yeah, you
gotta go to the giant violin for sure.
And then we went on to our Airbnb.
Yeah, George's River.
It was a really nice Airbnb, well done, and all that kind of stuff. So
that was on
it sounds like brass door. That's what. Yeah. Not brass door. Brass door.
Yeah. So that's where we went. And it's a gorgeous spot. It's worth a stop for sure.
Like, 3 days in Cape Breton is really the least amount of time really that you need to be able to get in there and around and see some of the stuff. We still did fairly minimal. There's like endless amounts of hiking and things that you could see. A week to 2 weeks is
better,
probably better, and would be great to be able to do sometime, and we hope to be able to do that. But no less than 3 days, really.
Yeah.
I can't imagine you can get, you might be able to just zip around the Cabot Trail for less than that, but 3 days is what you need. So enjoy the clips. And I hope someday you guys get to cut here and see all these things for yourself.
Absolutely.
Go ahead.
Until next time, join us
every further mile. What?
Interview the Champ family?
Can you tell me where to start? I need someone to empty this heart. Now would help. Let me give you a piece of advice, she said. Larger ain't bolder, and wiser ain't older. Just hold on to what you believe in. On dancing, yes, we've traveled far, seen so many dogs.
Bonjour,
bonjour,
bonjour, bonjour, bonjour.